In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Spirit of God, come and inspire in us. Set us on fire for the love of Jesus on the cross, so that having lived in his love, we may live a witnessing life built on the foundation of the apostolic faith. May we ever grow deeper into the love and knowledge of Christ, so that Christ may be in us, so that he may live in us, so that we may proclaim his compassionate love for the entire cosmos. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear friends, we begin this week with the powerful and blessed name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Today the church celebrates the feast of the Apostle Bartholomew, one of the 12 apostles of Jesus. The name Bartholomew means, Bar means son of Ptolemy. And he was a devout Jew who was studying the scriptures, especially the Old Testament Torah, sitting under the fig tree. In those days, there were no classrooms and no universities or colleges. So the rabbis used to expound the scriptures, the teaching of the Torah, under the fig tree, because the fig tree provided double benefits. One was their leaves were so broad and they gave their shadow. And second benefit was there was also fig fruit, sufficient enough to ease their hunger. Therefore, the fig tree was those days' class where they held the learning of Torah. Therefore, when Jesus saw him before Philip called him under the fig tree, Nathanael was expecting the coming of the Messiah. Therefore, the Lord, after seeing him, Nathanael, also other name of Bartholomew, synonymous with this person. So the Lord tells him, behold, the true Israel, in him there is no guile. My dear friends, of the 12 apostles of Jesus, each one was unique in his own way. And this disciple this apostle is known as the person without guile. The book of Sirach tells, the eyes of the Lord are 10,000 times brighter than the sun. Therefore, we need not to hide anything before him. Everything the Lord knows and he sees. Therefore, we must surrender as we are, with our limitations and our strength, to the mercy of God. We read in today's first reading from the book of Revelation about the heavenly Jerusalem and the heavenly temple. How with the 12 gates, people from all different nations will enter throng into the house of God. And upon the 12 gates were written the 12 names of the slaughtered lamb standing and the disciples, the apostles of the slaughtered lamb standing. That means these 12 apostles. My dear friends, today if we believe in the name and power of our Lord Jesus Christ, it is because of the bloodshed of these apostles who were so convinced and committed that they went far and near proclaiming the good news. The tradition and the history tells us that Saint Bartholomew went to Arabia and there he proclaimed the good news. He also came to India in the region of the Diocese of Vasai and Sirimalapur Diocese of Kalyan near Bombay, and there he proclaimed the good news. Not only that, he also left a copy of the Hebrew Bible according to Matthew, which the historian Pentanius records in his diary. Therefore, having received the apostolic faith, we must stand firm in conviction of love of our Lord Jesus Christ, crucified, died and risen, and who lives, who is the same yesterday and today and tomorrow. Let us pray for such profound faith and love in Jesus. Just as these apostles, we may always live a life of witnessing to the Jesus, our Lord and Savior and intimate friend. Hide me now under your wings, cover me within your mighty hand. When the oceans rise and thunder roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God. Yes, I will be still and know you are God. Find rest, my soul, in Christ alone. Know his power in quietness and trust. When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God. Yes, I will be still and know you are God. When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God. Yes, I will be still and know you are God. Let us pray. Jesus, our Savior and Redeemer, we thank you for the example of faith and model of life you have given us through the apostles who went far and near, not counting the difficulties, the torture, the punishment that they had to endure, but rather in the love of you and in commitment and dedication of life, consecration of those, their souls to your most sacred heart, they lived for you and for you alone. Give us such inspiring and committed life so that we may stand firm in the faith of you, so that we may never compromise ourselves with the values of the world, rather may make you known through our lives of witnessing. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.